This conference will now be recorded.
Now, we had done single inheritance and multi-level. Hope we'll continue with the hierarchical and the other one is what? And then we understand, let's discuss about quickly about the other stuff. What is that? Why it's not supported, multiple inheritance thing, we'll see, and then we'll switch to the polymorphism after that, okay? Right, so let me open the document. So what is this we're talking here? Inheritance. Okay, we have done that. And this is discussed yesterday. We have done single inheritance, multi-level inheritance. You know about that, right? Inheritance thing. The advantage is inheritance avoids data redundancy. That is one thing. The other thing is it also provides code reusability. That anyhow, that happens with methods. Wherever we use methods, definitely that code reusability is always there. Then we have seen how data redundancy is avoided with the inheritance with examples in yesterday's session, right? So now we have to go with what? Multi-level inheritance is done. So we have to go with the hierarchical inheritance. It doesn't take much time for us because those are all simple topics. So today, let's quickly discuss about hierarchical inheritance. What is this here? This is simplest, we can say this as a one to many. What we can tell about this? It's more, it's nothing but hierarchical means one parent, many children. If we inherit two or more children from our two or more child classes or subclasses from a parent class, then we call it as hierarchical inheritance. So deriving, this is a simple thing, deriving two or more subclasses from a superclass or from a parent class, same thing this one. From a parent class, that is one thing. Okay, next one. It's more or less we can say one to many, one parent, many children. Okay. Even this kind of relationships exist in object-oriented programming. Suppose in Java, there is something called Hibernate. It's called ORM tool. It talks about the relationships, even that is there in database also, even that exists between objects as well. Got it right there. One to many means one parent, many children. Many to many means, many to one means many parents, one child. Like that we can see that, okay. So, now the diagram look like this. You have a class A. From this class A, we can inherit class B, class C, class D. And this can keep, this keeps going there, right? It continues like that. Now here A is a parent and B and C are what? B and C are B, C and then D, these are all child classes. And the point here is, here all these childs are inherited from this parent and one child doesn't have any direct relation with another child. We cannot access properties of one child to another child, it's not possible here. But here in this inheritance, the child class can have access to properties of parent. Have access to parent alone, not with the other child. Means what? One child don't have access to another child. That is what I mean. Got it, right? It's more or like you know, like a company. Best example is the company. Company, if company is parent, employees are kids. But you know, one employee is different from other employee. Suppose if I get salary, I don't give it to other employee, right? So that is what this is. But just quick example to understand, that's all. Maybe it doesn't make sense, that is fine. Okay. So now that's the idea about hierarchical inheritance, one parent, many children. Now, what do you do right now? You just do a small program, continue with the same, what we have tried with yesterday's multi-level. So now you can rewrite the same program from multi-level. What is that you can do? You have A class here, class A. And then this is a parent class and declare attributes here, AB, and then two methods, take one class B. This time B has to be inherited from A and C has to be inherited from A itself. Earlier in multi-level, we inherited C from B, but now it's not C from B. C has to be inherited from A. For all child classes, the parent is this A itself. Okay, got it right there. This is a simple idea here, sir. All of you are clear, no? This is the idea about what is that hierarchical. One thing is here one child don't have access to another child. And another important point is we should create separate object for every child class so that we can access properties of that child as well as its parent. As we don't have any correlation or interconnection between one child to another child, we should create a separate object for every child class. That is another important. So you can rewrite the same program for hierarchical inheritance. The multi-level, you can rewrite this to hierarchical. So how do you do it? It's a simple thing. Why don't you try this now? Now test this program. Try this program. Then I will try to provide the solution. Then we can discuss. And then switch to the multiple inheritance and whether it supports or not. Then we will move to the polymorphism. Possible we will start today itself. Otherwise, on next class. Yeah, hi guys. Let me show you how to do this hierarchical inheritance program. I hope you have done it, no doubt about that. Just for analysis purpose, that's all. So here I'm using the same program. I have three classes A, B and C here. Now what is hierarchical? One parent, many children. And here parent is A here. And all the chains has to be inherited from A itself. Now B should be extended from A. There is no change for B class. Now C has to be extended from A, not from B here. So I should make a change here. Excuse me. When I make change here to A, immediately I got an error here. Can you see? With variable C here. Why? Because C is a variable of B class, and one class don't have access to other class directly. So in this case, I cannot access properties of B directly. So that's why it's showing error, because we don't have any direct relation here. So remove this. This is done. Perfect. Now you can see in both the classes, these were using the properties of its parent. Can you see this? A and B are from A class, and A and B here are from A class. But the operation might be different. You don't need to worry about it, right? This is simple idea about hierarchical. This time you can see I created object for C here. You can see an error. Sum belongs to B class, and I cannot call this on C class because C can have access to properties of its own class as well as its parent. So I cannot call sum, which is a property of B class, C class object. So what should I do right now? I should create one more object here, var space b equal to new b. And then what is that I have to do? B dot, what is that I should do, folks? 1 minute, folks. B dot set data. And then B dot get data. And then what should I do? B dot, of course, I will fix the error. I should put there the B1. That's not an issue. And then save this. We are done, right? So you can see here, as discussed, we created two separate objects for these subclasses, one for B and one for C. And if you observe carefully, B can have access to only properties of itself as well as its parent. And likewise, it is same for C as well. Correct. That's it, sir. Just run this code. And this is hierarchical. We got outputs. 1020 from A class, 30 from B class. 1020 from A class, 200 from C class. That's it, sir. Maybe you can add some prints here. If you want, you can add some text with prints to give more meaningful output. But for analysis purpose, this is enough for us, sir. Okay. This is the idea about hierarchy. Okay. What do we do right now? Where is the? What do we do right now? We go for multiple inheritance. Multiple. What is multiple inheritance? 1 minute, folks, 1 minute. Sorry guys, I'm middle of something, so I need to attempt it. So multiple inheritance, what is it? Many to one. What do you mean by many to one? Many parents, one children. To quickly remember, I used to tell this when I was in, when I was a exclusive teacher, assistant professor. This is an American system. Many parents, one children. Just to remember, I don't mean anything else here. So, many to one. So, what is it? Deriving or inheriting? You can say anything is fine, sir. Deriving two or more subclasses. Sorry, deriving a subclass from two or more parent classes. Parent classes. It might be 2, 3, 4, how many ever you want, you can take that many. It depends on the requirement usually. But probably for us, I don't think this is supported, but we'll just quickly check this here so that we can have a practical proof that inheritance is not directly supported with classes. If it is not supported, means it's not like it is completely avoided. We do it in a different way. That's the point. That's the meaning of that. Okay? Like just now today, our finance minister is saying, write-off is different from wave-off, like that. If it is not supported, means it doesn't mean that we are avoiding it, but we do it in a different way. So I take two different classes. I don't want this much bigger session, bigger program. Just enough, this is enough, two classes are enough. Now, no need of anything in the classes, just to test that whether multiple inheritance is possible or not. We don't need methods or variables inside that, just we need some empty classes. Now I have two classes here, A and B. Now I am extending both the classes A and B into C. How do I do that? I simply just say that, what is that? C1 extends A1 comma B1. This is how generally we do. Okay. Correct. Okay. This is how we do here. Extends A1 comma B1. But you can see an error here. What is that error? Can you see that error, sir? Can you see that? Means what? This is not supported in, maybe I'll remove this closing bracket. But if I try to inherit two or more parents to one subclass, this is not supported in Java or C sharp or in this scalar. If you see, there is an error. Of course, it is not saying what is that, but still we can understand that we cannot inherit multiple parents to a subclass. One parent can be inherited. At most, we can inherit one parent, one superclass. Got it, right? But it's not possible for inheriting multiple parents to a subclass. So why? Because this is avoided here in Java. Means why? Because there is an issue called deadly diamond problem. What is that deadly diamond problem? Suppose you have a method M1 in A class. Again, you have this same method M1 in B class. Okay. Now you know you inherit A and B, sir. Now the problem is for C class. Now C is in confusion. Why? Both parents give same method. Which method should I take here? Should I take M1? Should I take M1 from A class or M1 from B class? This is an ambiguity for C class. The child has this ambiguity. And such issue generally people call this, if you look at the hybrid inheritance example, they will call this as a deadly diamond problem. Maybe I'll show you here. Let me show you one interesting example for you. So now we have parents like this. This is A, sir. Okay. This is A. From A, we are inheriting B and C. we are inheriting BC. And then again, we are inheriting one more subclass from them. So this has both combinations, sir. It has both hierarchical and multiple inheritance inside this. Following, sir. Now you see here, this is assume that you can give any subclass names, any names, that's your choice, sir. This is B, this is C, this is D, sir. Okay. Now, sir, if you see, we are inheriting B from A and B from C from A. By now, you know this is hierarchical inheritance. And now I am inheriting D from B and D from C, correct? Now suppose, sir, assume that this A class A has M1 member. This is hybrid inheritance, sir, because it has combination of hierarchical as well as it has multiple. If you look at this left side, left part and right part, even that is also multi-level. You can see there is a multi-level implicitly involved here. Can you see that? If you look at that left side and right side, it looks like multi-levels. Okay. So now I have M1 in A class, sir. When I have M1, what happens now? This M1 is inherited to B, inherited to C. All of you know that, right? Now I am inheriting D from B and C. Now this D has the issue. Now there is an ambiguity for D. Which M1 does B should take here? Does it? 1 minute, guys. Should it take M1 from B class or should it take M1 from C class? This is the ambiguity issue. And this situation, we call this as a deadly diamond problem. You can see when you look at the diagram, it's a bit like, it looks like a diamond here, right? The architecture looks like a diagram here. The figure looks like diamond. So people named, it's not my thought process, sir. I'm not giving you anything of my own here. Technically, Java people, James Gossin, you know, all this came from Java or C++. Okay, because the object-oriented mostly comes from C++. The CPP people and Java people name this as what? They name this as something called deadly diamond problem. Okay, deadly diamond problem. And what they do, what these people do, this language people, what they had done here. C++ people managed this issue by using a concept called virtual base class. CPP people. Java people thought that because they avoid this pointers, everything in Java directly, indirectly pointers might be there. They avoid it, direct pointers, and also they thought to remove all the confusions in Java. So that's why in Java, what Java people thought is, this is a bit confusion and ambiguous. So Java people completely avoided this. They ignored this. They didn't support it in Java directly. Means it doesn't mean that it is completely removed, but it is implemented with the triads in Scala and interfaces in Java, even interfaces in C# also. Got it right, sir? So this is simple idea about the issue with multiple inheritance. If you see wherever, even the issue here in this diagram, if you look at the diagram, the issue is coming with this multiple inheritance only at the bottom level. The bottom level inheritance is causing the problem. When you have multiple parents and one child, the child is getting confused to take or to get that method from which class, from which parent, either from B or from C. And here the actual reason is because of what? Again, multiple inheritance. Why we have ambiguity? Multiple inheritance. That's why Java people have avoided multiple inheritance with classes. But if you ask me, don't we have multiple inheritance in Java or in Scala? Maybe you can, you might think we are in Scala class and JSR is, you know, trying to tell Java. Scala is completely developed in Java, sir. So most of the libraries of Java, you can directly use in Scala. You know, when you look at our project every day, many utility classes they develop in Java and they import in scalar program. That is called interoperability. See how powerful it is then. If it is scalar, scalar doesn't have only power of scalar, it has power of Java. Java has power of C and C++. You see, if we're just talking like that, it's a big ocean. So finally, the conclusion is what, sir? This is the idea about multiple inheritance. The issue with multiple inheritance is the child might have ambiguity with the parents whenever these parents have same methods. Okay, that is one thing. Okay, that's why the scalar people didn't support this. However, even though we don't directly support with classes, again, we have to underline this statement. It is not supported with classes, but still this multiple inheritance can be implemented with something called triads. What is that we can do, sir? So a quick point, scalar doesn't support what, sir? Multiple inheritance with classes. Why? Because at most you can inherit one parent to one child. That's all, sir. However, we can implement multiple inheritance with what, sir? Triads here. Use something called multiple inheritance with something called triads. Actually, this triad, just for naming this thing, I just say triads or with triad. Okay, leave it. You got it right, sir? Hope you got clarity about what is deadly diamond problem, why multiple inheritance is not supported. The reason, what is the actual problem we have if we have multiple inheritance with classes, the ambiguity issue, right? So this is all about it. Suppose in Python, anyhow, they created something else. They have implemented this to handle this ambiguity. They took some other precaution there. But in Java, in Scala, in C Sharp even, this issue persists. Got it right, sir? All of you are clear now? So this is the idea about what, sir? This is the idea about multiple inheritance and hybrid inheritance. Okay, even we have just seen a quick example of hybrid where it has a very big deadly diamond issue. Okay, hybrid means collection of, it's nothing but what is that? Combination of two or more inheritances. That's what we call hybrid here, sir. Okay, if you want, you can mix hierarchical with the multi-level, or you can mix single anyhow. By default, single inheritance is everywhere, right? Got it, right? So that's the idea about inheritance. We have successfully completed inheritance now. And there are many more things we need to cover now. There are so many underlying things. Okay, we need to talk about that. So we need to talk about what after this inheritance? Polymorphism. Today what I will do is, I will introduce polymorphism, and we will also understand many more important scenarios, and also we will see like what is the concept of loose coupling that is best understood with polymorphism, sir. Now there is very important thing. People don't have an idea here about loose coupling. Loose coupling is one of the famous and one of the very important topic which exists in most of the OOP languages. You go to the Spring, you go to Hibernate, you go to, I'm talking about Java, or you go to some .NET applications, or you go to some Scala applications, sir. This loose coupling is one of the most used topic or concept. Very useful, sir. Okay, that you understand better with polymorphism. Got it, right? So what is polymorphism? Now after finishing this inheritance, after completing inheritance, we understood a couple of things. What is that? We can inherit properties of one class to another class. I'm just concluding. This is not something difficult for anyone. I know that. This is one of the most simple and most easiest topic in the whole object-oriented program. then there is so much here. If you want to discuss about inheritance, still we can discuss at least two to three hours again. Got it, right? But now, for now, we are concluding here. Okay, what is that? What is this inheritance here? Extending or inheriting one parent to one child. For that, we use the keyword extends. And then also, what is the point here? We have different types of inheritances: single, multi-level, and hierarchical, which are supported in scalar. And here we have scalar don't support multiple inheritance directly with the classes, but however, we can implement that with the multiple inheritance with tribes. And also, when you go for hybrid inheritance, when there is a combination of hierarchical and multi-level, we face an issue called deadly diamond problem. That diamond issue exists because of the having multiple inheritance in the hierarchy. Anywhere we have multiple inheritance, there is an ambiguity for a subclass with the parents, and that is clearly explained with an example, also with diagram. Also, we have seen a program as well, and where we have some error there. And we have seen here, even if you put different methods here, not same methods, this is not supported in scalar. Okay, if I put this as M2, still this won't work. Don't think that if methods are same, this issue will come here. No, sir, it's not like that. Even if you declare different methods, still scalar doesn't support this. It doesn't support. It's not there in scalar. Okay. Excuse me. So that's the idea about this, sir. Now I am jumping to polymorphic. Poly means many. These are all simple things, sir, because as you are, most of you are working people, I think almost everyone is working here. These are very basic things, sir. Poly means many. Morphism means forms. Even for students, there is nothing here. If it is a beginner or a student, morphism means forms. So here, usually polymorphism talks about methods, sir, here. It's about methods. How you represent methods, that is what polymorphism concentrates. It's not like it's not about classes or variables. It's more about methods here. How can we represent methods? In how many forms we can represent methods? And also how methods can be declared between superclass and subclass, or parent and child. Now you know inheritance. Now that inheritance is also used here to understand, to implement polymorphism, one type of polymorphism. Okay, we'll talk about it. So poly means many, morphism means forms. It's like, you know, same method represented in many forms. Many forms. And what do you call this, gentleman? It is known as polymorphism. And there are so many examples in real life for polymers. Okay, like, you know, you know many movies like Dasavatar, you know, the Telugu movie, because we are from South India and Hyderabad. So that Kamal Hassan is in 10 forms. It is polymorphism. Aparchitudu, you know. Aparchitudu. Guys. Sorry, I have a call. Probably I'm not sure. This is an office call. If I am not able to come back in 5 minutes, you please you know, log off. Again, we'll continue tomorrow. Sorry for the inconvenience. Understood, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. Correct. Correct. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. True. Yes, I don't know. Yes, Sarona. Yeah, yeah. You even you keep us you keep us telling, right, Sarona? Make sure that true that is always false. Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. I understood. Yeah. Sorry, team, are you there? Hello? Hello?
Yeah, Manohar.
Yeah, sorry, I had a call from office, so I have to take it.
It's okay. If you want to continue with that, you can go ahead. We can continue tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah. Anyhow, we are almost, the time is up there. So maybe if you, I don't have an issue, I can spend for 20 more minutes. I don't have a problem if you are comfortable. But, you know, I see some of the folks missing the
session. Few people, three to four people have dropped out.
Yeah, yeah. So why don't we make it tomorrow? We'll finish
sure,
up.
No problem.
Tomorrow, holiday for all of you, right?
Yes.
It's a May Day, right?
Yeah, yeah.